Hello students, let's discuss about trends in data warehousing. First, we will see the introduction about data warehousing. Next, we will discuss the difference between data warehousing and data mining. Finally, we will discuss about various trends in data mining. Data warehousing is defined as the collection of corporate information and data derived from operational systems and external data sources. A data warehouse is designed with the purpose of inducing business decisions by allowing data consolidation, analysis, and reporting and at different aggregate levels. Data is populated into the data warehouse by extraction, transformation, and loading operation, which is nothing but ETL. Data warehousing incorporates data stores and conceptual, logical, and physical models to support business goals and end user information needs. Creating a data warehouse requires mapping data between sources and targets, then capturing the details of the transformation in a metadata repository. The data warehouse provides a single comprehensive source of current and historical information. Let's see the relationship between data mining and data warehousing. The primary difference between data warehousing and data mining is that data warehousing is the process of compiling and organizing data into one common database, whereas data mining refers to the process of extracting meaningful data from the database. These two concepts are interrelated. Data mining begins only after data warehousing has taken place. In recent days, data warehousing has become mainstream. In the early stages, the major factors that drove many companies to move into data warehousing include, number one, huge competition in government deregulation, number two, need to revamp internal processes, and number three, customized marketing. Telecommunication, banking, and the retailer were the first industries to adopt data warehousing. Actually, retail business moved into data warehousing because of huge competition. The utility companies joined the group as that sector was deregulated. The next wave of the business to get into data warehousing consisted of companies in financial services, healthcare, insurance, manufacturing, pharmaceuticals, transportation, and distribution. At present, the data warehouses exist in every conceivable industry. Next, we can discuss the various trends in data warehousing. First, we will see the datafication. The datafication of the enterprise requires more capable data warehouses. Mobile devices, social media traffic, networked sensors, that is Internet of Things, which is booming now, and other sources are generating growing streams of data. Information technology teams are responding by adding new capabilities to data warehouses, so they can handle large volume of new types of data in a faster manner. And next comes physical and logical consolidation. Physical and logical consolidation help reduce cost. So, growing data warehouses must be consolidated through the combination of virtualization, compression, multi-tenant databases, and servers that are engineered to handle much larger data volumes and workloads. Next important trend followed in data mining field is Hadoop. Hadoop optimizes the data warehouse environments. This is the open source environment. The open source Hadoop program with its distributed file system called HDFS and parallel MapReduce paradigm excels at processing very large data sets. Thus, Hadoop optimizes data warehouse environments and is a great companion to standard data warehouses. A growing number of data warehouse managers are now using Hadoop to shoulder some of the heaviest workloads. Next, customer experience strategies. Here, customer experience strategies use real-time analytics to improve marketing campaigns. Data warehouses play a pivotal role in customer experience initiatives because they house the data used to establish a comprehensive 360-degree view of the customer base. It can be used for sentiment analysis, personalization, marketing, automation, sales, and customer service. Next comes engineered systems. Engineered systems are becoming a preferred approach for large-scale information management. Here, we are talking about Oracle Big Data Appliance and Oracle Extract Data Database Machine are becoming a preferred approach for large-scale information management. These engineering systems are pre-configured and optimized for specific kinds of workloads, delivering the highest level of performance without the integration and configuration headaches. Next important trend is on-demand analytics environment. On-demand analytics environment meet the growing demand for rapid prototyping and information discovery. Technical breakthroughs such as Oracle Database 12c's pluggable database feature make it easy for administrators to provide sandbox platform in a data warehouse environment for use in support of new analytics projects. Next trend is data compression. Data compression enables higher volume, higher value analytics. The best way to counter non-stop data expansion is data compression. Advanced compression methods like hybrid columnar compression are used recently. Using compression technique, companies can capture and store more valuable data. Next important trend to be discussed is in-database analytics. In-database analytics simplify analysis. Data warehouse will have a range of ready-to-use tools like SQL integration with R programming language and the data mining algorithms to jumpstart and facilitate data analysis. These kinds of in-database analytics capabilities minimize the need to move data back and forth to other systems and applications for analysis, resulting in more streamlined and optimized data discovery. Next, we will discuss about in-memory technologies. In-memory technologies supercharge the performance. The emergence of in-memory database architecture brings super fast performance to the data warehouses. The term in-memory refers to the ability to process large data sets in the system's RAM, accelerating number crunching and reporting of actionable information. Data warehouses are more crucial than ever to business operations. Data warehouses have been around for years. Their values keeps growing because they represent a company's crown jewels, which are nothing but the data about the customers and business performance. Organizations are finding new applications for data warehouses. For example, healthcare providers are using enterprise data warehouses to improve patient care and streamline operations. Next trend is consolidating to private clouds. Recent days, we are talking more about cloud environment for maximizing the performance. Here, consolidating to private clouds maximizes flexibility and reduces costs. Forward-looking companies are consolidating standalone servers into private clouds. They can expand or reduce the capacity of any database to meet the dynamic nature of the workload at hand. Next important trend is business analytics. Business analytics get more accessible. Analytic applications provide a significant competitive advantage, especially in fast-moving industries with very large data sets such as telecommunication, finance, and retail. to support all types of analytic applications, an integrated high performance platform that can easily store, organize, manage, analyze, backup and archive all types of data is required. This platform should be available to executive mid-level managers, business analysts and operational users within the enterprise and to customers and partners outside the organization. Next is big data. Big data infiltrates the enterprise. Capturing and analyzing all data including unstructured, semi-structured and traditional data that allows managers to gain a more thorough understanding of their business. Now, there is big data, real-time data, multi-structured data, analytic data and machine data, all converging with new paradigms like Hadoop, MapReduce and personal clouds. When properly analyzed, this information can provide unique knowledge into market trends, business opportunities, maintenance cycles and many other business issues, enabling organizations to operate more efficiently and competitively. Next comes flash and DRAM. Increased performance with flash and DRAM. Today's modern hardware platforms improve performance by managing data in server memory, reducing latency and eliminating I/O operations that are the bottleneck for large queries. Having a cache of ultra-fast DRAM memory coupled to a flash infrastructure delivers tremendous performance to improvements. IT leaders are focusing on achieving that right balance between flash, DRAM and disk to maximize performance in lowering their costs. Next, high availability becomes essential for mission critical data warehousing. Data warehousing workloads becoming mission critical. Enterprises rely on their information flowing from them to support operational analytics and make business decisions in real time. Many of these organizations are deploying high availability data warehouse solutions that enable continuous access to information that including during planned and unplanned outages with zero downtime. Next, we will see the significant trends in data warehousing. In the next few more years, the data warehousing is expected to make big growth in software, especially for number one, optimizing the queries, number two, indexing very large tables, number three, enhancing structured query language, number four, improving data compression methods, five, expanding dimensional modeling, six, real-time data warehousing, number seven, data visualization, number eight, parallel processing software implementation to the data warehouse application, and finally, multi-dimensional analysis and predictive analytics. To conclude, a data warehouse is designed with the purpose of inducing business decisions by allowing data consolidation analysis and reporting at different aggregate levels. Data warehousing is the process of compiling and organizing data into one common database, whereas data mining refers the process of extracting meaningful data from that database. The major trends in data mining include datafication of the enterprise, the open source Hadoop program with its distributed file system HDFS, on-demand analytics environment, in-database analytics and in-memory technologies, use of flash and DRAM for better performance. Thank you.